Good morning, boys and girls, to Shawnee Presbyterian Church. We have a fantastic Bible story today called Elijah and the Time of No Rain. Interesting, a time of no rain. I guess we call that a drought sometimes. Elijah and the Time of No Rain. This is based on a Bible reading as well. King Ahab was a wicked king. He set up idols of Baal and altars of Baal along the paths in the woods. You can see the woods here. See these altars right here? And this is the king here. "Pray to Baal," he said to the people. "Baal sends the rain to make your fields and gardens grow." King Ahab built a beautiful temple. He placed the ugly idol of Baal in the temple. "Pray to Baal," he said. "Baal sends the rain." Prophet Elijah looked down from the mountains where he lived in a little house built of stones. He saw the temple of Baal. It made him weep. God came near and talked with Prophet Elijah. "I will teach the king and the people that it is I, the Lord, who sends the rain and not the idol of Baal. Go tell King Ahab," he said, "that there will be neither dew nor rain until the people of Israel turn away from idols." Neither dew or rain. So the morning dew would not come and no rain would fall from the sky. That would be very difficult for people. And back then, people relied on agriculture and farming for just to live. See the farms down here? See, this is the city here, and there's Elijah. You're back in the king's castle here at the palace. Down the mountainside hurried Prophet Elijah, across the valley to the king's palace, past the king's soldiers. Elijah did not stop until he stood before the king. King Ahab, "As the Lord God liveth," he told the king, "there shall be neither dew nor rain until the people of Israel turn away from idols." Wow, that's a big statement to make. Just to walk before the king and say, "There'll be no rain." Wow. Then Prophet Elijah quickly left the king's palace. God whispered to him, "Hide yourself beside the brook Cherith." The brook is a type of small stream. "Catch Elijah, stop him," shouted the king. "Don't let him get away." But Elijah was already gone. The soldiers ran in all directions to find him. They went to his mountain home, but Elijah was not there. They hunted for him in the fields, but Elijah was not there. Even King Ahab joined in the search, but no one could find the prophet Elijah. Elijah had hid beside the brook Cherith. He drank the clear, cool water of the brook. Do you see the brook down here? Do you see the prophet Elijah here? Beautiful birds in the trees, a beautiful spot for Elijah to wait and hide himself from King Ahab. Every morning after the sun came up and every evening before the sun went down, God sent ravens to bring him food. Many, many days Elijah lived beside Brook Cherith. The wild creatures became his friends. Do you see any wild creatures in here? Because there was no rain, the grass turned brown, the leaves fell from the trees, and there was no grain to harvest. Finally, the brook Cherith dried up itself, and there was no water for Elijah to drink. But God did not forget him. God never forgets. "Go to the city of Zarephath," he told Elijah. "I have commanded a widow who lives there to give you food and water." Wow, commanded a woman who had lost her husband, a widow, to give him food and water. The widow of Zarephath was searching for wood near the city gate when Prophet Elijah came by, and Elijah asked her for a drink and some bread. Said the widow, "I have only a handful of meal and a little oil. I'm gathering two sticks to bake the last loaf of bread for me and my boy. After that, we must die." How sad. You see the widow here and her boy Elijah? Fear not, said Elijah. Make me a little cake, for God has said that the meal shall not lack, nor the oil fail until the day he sends rain. So Elijah is proclaiming his faith in God. He's proclaiming that God has singled him out as being special, just like God singles you out as being special. When you have faith, even in little things, and do small acts of kindness, they make a big difference in this world. There's the boy and the woman. She's making just a little cake for Elijah. The widow baked a little cake for Prophet Elijah and drew him a drink from the well. She gave him a room in the loft of their home. And it happened as God had said. Every morning there was a handful of meal in her barrel and a little oil in her cruse. Cruse is like a little porcelain or metal container for oil. Enough for the day's loaf of bread. And God sent water in the well. So during the time of no rain, the widow, the boy, and Elijah had bread to eat and water to drink. Oh dear, there's King Ahab. 3 years of no rain went by. Then one day God said to the prophet Elijah, go, show yourself unto King Ahab, and I will send rain upon the earth. Back to the land of Israel went prophet Elijah. He met King Ahab on a path. The king frowned at him. Look at the king frowning at him. Is it you, you troubler of Israel? I have not troubled Israel, said Elijah. You have, because you turned away from God. Gather all the people of Israel to me on Mount Carmel, commanded Elijah, and all the prophets of Baal. So Elijah commanded the king to do something. That shows that Elijah had faith and courage to stand up before a king and all the prophets of that idol that they worship. King Ahab did as the prophet Elijah said, and all the people of Israel and all the prophets of Baal gathered together on Mount Carmel. Can you guys see all those people? Even the children came. This day Elijah would prove who was the true God. Let us build two altars, said Elijah, one to the Lord and one to Baal. Let us place wood on the altars and an offering upon the wood. The God who answers by fire, he is God. All the people answered, it is well spoken. They meant, we agree to these terms. The prophets of Baal built their altar. They placed wood on the altar and an offering upon the wood. They prayed to Baal from morning until noon. O Baal, hear us, O Baal. There was no answer. They cried louder and louder. They leaped and they jumped around, leaping and jumping. And they cut themselves. Still, there was no answer. The prophets of Baal had not heard any word from this mistaken prophet. When it was evening, Elijah said to the people, come near unto me. And they came near. He built the altar of the Lord and dug a ditch. Around it he placed wood on the altar and an offering upon the wood. Then water was poured over the altar. It ran down and filled the ditch. The people watched and waited. Looking towards heaven, Elijah prayed, O Lord God, let it be known this day that thou art God. Almost before Elijah could say, Amen, so be it, Amen, fire flashed down from heaven like lightning. It burned up the offering. It burned up the wood. It even burned up the stones of the altar and the water in the ditch. And the people shouted, The Lord, he is God. The Lord, he is God. God heard them and was pleased. That night he sent a great rain to water the earth. And this is the next story. So we learned a few things about Elijah. We learned that in Israel they used to pray to idols, and that God sent a great drought a time of no rain to the earth, to teach the bad king a lesson, but also to show the people of the power of the Lord. But he also took pity on all the people, because in the end, he sent them that amazing substance, water. Think of water in your lives. Think of how important it is. You need it. 70% of your body is made of water. Think of the water in the streams from rain. But how about the snow, the wonderful snow we're having right now? It's been wonderful to talk to you, children and adults of Shawnee Presbyterian Church. I'm so glad we have the chance to spend these moments together. Goodbye.